Some of you I know, some of you I will get to know. Michael, what's up, dude?
Yeah, hi there.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. Another semester.
Here we go.
Am I in the right class? Is this everyday carry 101? Does anybody have a pencil sharpener I can borrow? I always get the question, George, I only have $100 to spend. I'm not trying to buy a $300 backpack. Which bag should I buy? I always point people to the 511 Rush series, particularly the 12, because it's a perfect size at 24 liters, right in the middle range, so you can carry enough stuff in your EDC. Today, I have an upgrade to an already, I guess I want to label it the budget champ for EDC backpacks. They've updated it. 2.0 version kind of snuck under the radar for me because I was like, damn, they updated their line. They put some new stuff in there. We need to check it out. So if you guys aren't familiar how my reviews work, I try to give you some of the technical specs, you know, the dimensions and things of that nature. Then I try to take you through the cooler sections, walk all the way around the bag and give you my final thoughts. And then we get the hell up out of here. That's how these reviews work. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump into these technical specs, all right? We got a bag that's 18 inches tall, it's 11 inches wide, and it's got a 6 inches of depth. Like I've already mentioned, it's 24 liters. Now, those are kind of some of the specs. Well, let me give you the weight too. The weight is 3 pounds, 15 ounces. So there we go. We got the specs out of the way. Oh, we might as well go ahead and talk about the price right now. 99 bucks. 99 bucks out here, that's a deal and a half. And I know some people are gonna be like, man, I can still go to Walmart and get me a Ozark Trail for like $40. You can, you definitely can. An Ozark Trail might last you, it may not last you, but I can definitely vouch for this. Let's stop talking, let's get into this bag. All right, let me show you the three things that they upgraded on this bag, all right? So first, CCW. For my CCW guys, the guys that want to carry a firearm with them, and sometimes they want to put it in a bag, maybe they want to take it off body and put it in a bag, this bag has it. It's right here in the back. So this front pocket right here, and then there's a slip pocket that goes right behind in here. I'm gonna pull out this, you know, this is a training weapon right here. This is a 9mm representation, but the bag itself has Velcro in here, and I have like one of those Maxpedition holsters stuck in here. You can hear the Velcro, but it's a really simple system. So there's a wide range of Velcro holsters out there. Vertex makes some, Maxpedition makes some. I know I'm leaving a lot of people off the list, but this can probably consider a larger CCW in today's standards, where people are carrying a lot smaller, shorter mags and things of that nature. So yeah, so this is just to show you that there are, you know, you can carry a larger firearm in this bag. So it slips in here. You got to kind of line up the holster with the nose of the weapon. So yeah, so it doesn't close with that larger weapon. It doesn't close too much. It's going to be really hard for you to see in there because it's no high-vis lining or anything like that. But you have like a little Velcro closure that helps to close that section. But CCW compartment added, check. Thank you very much, 511, because this is a brand that's really popular with, you know, the CCW crowd. Laptop compartment. Let's go ahead into the main section. What you do to get all the way in, you can get access to the top of the bag by just unzipping it, like a lot of bags. Just, you know, you have your compression straps on the side too. Really simple to just undo those and get into the main section. We'll talk about the main section while we're in there. And you can see how the layout is. Stuff falling out as usual. What else is new? So you got some organization over here. You can see my stuff. Yeah, water bottle inside. You know there's no water bottle on the outside. Anytime I stuck my water bottle inside, got my Sony XM3s, sunglasses in a case. Back here in the back, is the laptop compartment, suspended off the bottom 1 inch. And 5.11 specifically tells you that. I tried to stick my 17-inch laptop in there. It fit, but it was so tight. It was on the edges of the surrounding of the bag itself. Now, what I will say about this laptop compartment, I have my 15-inch Dell XPS in there. It fits. It's a snug fit. And one thing about the height of the surrounding of the bag right here, the depth of the bag, it makes it kind of difficult to actually get the laptop out. So you have to kind of pull this lid back some and then flip this over and then you can get to it. But like just trying to access the laptop and get it out from here, it wants to run into the fabric that's running around the sides of the bag. You do have like a little Velcro closure, and then you can pull it. You can pull it back, you know, pull the laptop forward. Let me show you. You can kind of pull the laptop forward and then lift it out. But that extra fabric does, you know, you just have to get, it's not a big deal. It's just something that you have to get used to. So that's one of the updates. While we're in here, we might as well talk about this section. High-vis lining in this bag would be appreciated. So inside, it's all black. This is the black version, so it's black in the interior. You know, I'm not sure about this interior lining, what denier it is, but it feels pretty decent. It feels high quality, like it's gonna last you a really long time. 5.11 has a pretty good warranty on their stuff. So on the lid right here, you got two pockets like you see in a lot of assault-style bags. The mesh on here, solid, really solid. You got YKK zips. I'm kind of not mad, but you know, they're trying to make this bag affordable. So you don't have paracord on the zipper pulls. It's like, you know, some kind of nylon cord they put on the zipper pulls. Easy fix. Get yourself, you know, a roll of 550 cord. This is a larger pocket down here. I was able to stick my Adventure Medical Kit in there. Let me pull it out for all of those folks that want to see it. Yeah. Put my Adventure Medical Kit down there. That's something that I always kind of carry in my bags. On the top, recycled firefighter truckie. You know, great, great, great little EDC pouches that recycled firefighter does. So I kind of stuck with that. That's something that's becoming like a staple in my bag, that recycled firefighter truckie pouch. As much as I don't, you know, I switch pouches, I really enjoy that one. But yeah, that's the interior section of the bag. You have a lot of space. There's a lot of space in this bag for you know, extra stuff, a change of clothes. I could even see you doing like a limited weekend trip in this bag, no problem. On the outside of the bag itself, you got number 10 YKK zips. They're not AquaGuard zippers. This is like the bag I would point out to a person if they're just getting kind of started in EDC and they don't want to spend a lot of money, but they want a solid, solid bag. Yeah, you really can't go wrong with this bag at all. So on the outside, you got a lot of pals or Molly webbing, however you want to say, it's a lot of it. So even though this bag doesn't have water bottle pockets on the side, you can add them. There's, I don't know, I really like the VanQuest water bottle that you can add. So you can hook it on the side here. You know, I don't mind mixing, matching brands, you know, just stuff that works. That's what I like. So the material on the outside of the bag is a 1050D nylon, really rugged and tough. You got a little bit of branding, super subdued. You can barely make it out, since 5.11. You have actually two morale patch. Well, one of them is a morale patch field, and then this is a tape field. So like if you wanted to put your name, if you have a name tape, if you're in the military, you put your name tape up there. That way you can tell the difference between your bag and somebody else's bag. In the front, I got my, you know, morale patch, sorry, with throw, Texas talk, baby. And up here at the top, this is the name tape, but I have this little light that Night Corps sent me over. This is the NU07LE. It has Velcro on the back, so you can stick it on things. And then it's a really simple functionality. You can actually hook this right into Molly or Pals webbing too. So it just has one button on it. And the one button, if you hold it, it gives you five different colors LED lights. It's pretty slick. So you just hold the button and then it should switch. All right, green. So it goes through five separate LED colors. So depending on which color you want to identify yourself at night, for my bike riders, helpful for my guys that walk home in the night, There you go. This thing is $30. I think it's well worth it because I love Nightcore quality. Nightcore quality stuff is awesome. And if you can also hook this on too, we'll use the Velcro. If you have those helmets that have Velcro on the side, you can use that as an indicator too. But I thought this was a very cool little light that very happy that Nightcore sent over to me to check out, man. They sent me a couple of things, so we'll check those things out as the videos go on. But really, on the outside of this bag, back to the bag now, really just a whole bunch of Molly. So for those folks that are like on the fence kind of about, is Molly too technical in an urban setting? Probably this is probably not the bag. For those people that really don't care, like me, functionality over form, yeah, it's just that's Molly on my bag. Enough people have Molly bags out there. They ain't really worried about what you got going on. So inside the front pocket right here, you have some organization. I just did a review on this. This is the modern day fare tech pouch. I've moved to this. You see how slim it is? The slimness is crazy. I'm gonna put the link for the review of this up in the corner of the screen. Awesome little tech pouch. They haven't changed too much in the organization of this pocket right here. Really, it's not basic, it's functional. That's the best word I can come up with to use. So you got multiple little slip pockets over here. I got the Cold Steel American Lawman, great knife, great knife. Hellcyon, what is this? Not Hellcyon, this is S35VN steel. And the finger choil on this thing is great for people with big hands. I love this knife. Don't know how, I hope that Cold Steel keeps on making that knife right there. Different little slip pockets. You got some pen pockets right here where I have a Sharpie and a G2 Pilot pen. You do have a key keeper. I got my office keys in there. Plastic clip though, I would like to see a metal clip in here. You got a zippered pocket. I don't have anything in there. Smaller YKK zips, but you can stick some items in there. And then on the lid, you have some pockets. Now these pockets will fit, I think they fit AR mags. If you wanted to run an, if you're carrying an AR, you want to put your mags in there, you can, or any other kinds of magazines or just regular EDC stuff. I've seen people kit this thing out as their whole, like a really extensive medical kit right here in the front. But for me, the tech pouch goes in there, and yeah, that's about where that thing stops and ends at. But you got a quick access pocket. You really have two. This is another upgrade to the bag right here. So there's a quick access pocket right here on the top. I think this, like a smaller wallet, my smaller Mallet & Mall wallet and my keys should fit in there. It is fleece lined, so it should protect your laptop. They describe it as a sunglasses pocket. So, me trying to put my cell phone and keys in there may be a stretch, but I like to do what I want with my bag. So then you have another pocket right here in the front where I just put some wet wipes, but that's a good size pocket as well. The grab handle on the bag, it's not a regular piece of nylon webbing. It's probably about 1.5 inches and it's folded over. Nice grab to it. Stands away from the bag. You can get your whole hand under it. I consider this a budget bag. Great, awesome. You know what I mean? Because there's more expensive bags that do it worse than this. So this is awesome. Now, the best thing about this 511 bag is the back panel. This harness system that they've used in the iterations of this bag for the last couple of years is awesome. It's comfortable. It's yoke style system. If you like to ride your pack high, it's comfortable around your neck. If you like to wear it lower, the shoulder straps, great density to them. No mesh on the back. It's just got this nylon material, but I think that for this bag, this is a bag that you just buy and you do what the hell you want with it. You throw it around. It's rugged, tough. So a mesh, I'm not mad that they went with the, just like a slicker nylon. It is soft. It is comfortable. They did try to give you some raised panels here, so to give you a little bit of airflow. So I think overall for what this bag is, for $99, yeah, they did a good job. I can't, no complaints about these shoulder straps at all. For the price. Now, they do have the quick disconnect feature to them. So for those guys that plan on ditching your bag. Maybe you're a ninja. Maybe you on working field ops somewhere. You need to ditch your bag. You can. Great sternum strap on this bag as well. Really wide. 1 inch wide piece of nylon webbing here. Lock you in. And it has some elasticity to it. For me, on a 24 liter bag, probably not going to use it. But that is what it is. You do have a hip belt option, but for real, 24 liter pack, I don't see where you would need a hip belt in any scenario, really. I really wouldn't need it. But for those guys that would, they have a scenario that I haven't thought about, it's there for you. It's an optional thing. I think you have to purchase it from 5-Eleven. Back in the back here, this back panel also acts as your hydration bladder compartment. So you can unzip there. You have your rigid frame sheet in this part of the pack, but this should fit a nice little liter, you know, water bladder inside. You got your hanger loop, and there's a little hole up here at the top to let your water bladder come out and keep yourself hydrated. But man, for real, so I went over the three separate things that they upgraded: laptop compartment, CCW compartment, and this quick access. I think for 2021, this thing still sits at the top of the charts as far as for price. $99 is going to be hard for me to be like, if you need a rugged bag, it's right there at the top, man. 5-Eleven knows what they're doing. I actually like everything in that line of bags as far as the Rush series. Far as the price is awesome. And you can get this bag on sale sometimes for like $89, $80, $70 I've seen, you know, from time to time. Yeah, man, this thing is really hard to beat. It's a great solid bag. If you ask me, George, I got $100 to spend, what bag should I get? This the bag I'm gonna tell you to go get. Cause this, if you need a little bit more space, you can move up to the 24. And I think they even have a 72. So, yeah, that whole line of bags is great. I use you know, like the 72 for a travel scenario. It gives you a lot of space, rugged as hell. Don't care about it. Going in the woods, camping. This thing does well in the city. Take it in the woods. Take it wherever you need to take it, and it's a great value, man. That's my final thought, man. It's unknockable. $100. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do out here, guys? Thanks for watching George the Find. If you like this video, what do? You hit the thumbs up button. It gets the video out to more people. I say this in every ending because it's important. It's important. All right. If you got a question, leave it down there in the comments. Holler at your boy. Your boy is down in the comments reading your questions. What bag is better than this bag, and this bag is better than this bag? I'll let you know. I've touched a lot of bags at this point. Check out my playlist of bags. I spent like, I don't know, man, like it had to be a couple hours putting all the videos of my bags, and I even made a playlist of my best bags that are like smaller bags, larger bags, travel EDC pouches. Check that list out, man. If you want some suggestions for bags, maybe you don't like this one, you'll see something else that you like. But I'll see you guys in the next one, man.